Hi, welcome. My name is Llewellyn van der Merwe. I am the developer of Component Builder for Joomla. I would also be giving you the instructions of how to use it. Just want to look at a few issues. Component Builder was built for those who know PHP. If you don't know PHP, there are some great places to start learning from, and two of those I would mention is lynda.com and Udemy. You could go onto their websites and you can simply search for PHP and you would find tons of courses that I suppose would do more than enough to get you on your way. If you don't know CSS or JavaScript or HTML, then certainly you need to go visit these websites and get that knowledge. It was not developed for those who have no developing skills, because simply I developed it actually for myself as a developer of components so that I can easily and quickly get most of the bulk of the code done, and I can just be focused on the actual custom code, which goes beyond the norm, and so that's what it's really made to do. If you don't have an understanding of the Joomla API, it's only going to be to your own disadvantage. It's not that difficult to get an understanding. You need to just be able to read PHP and open a Joomla website, go to libraries, start reading the classes, even go to Joomla's own components. That means you would simply go to a Joomla install, that's this one here, and you go to components and you would go to the content manager, look at its folder structures, then open, if you know CMV, then there's the controllers, there's the models, there's the views. Open a view, start opening the script itself, read through it. If you're using NetBeans, you can hold on to a function like that one and press Control Shift, and it'll show you where in your Joomla website that function is declared, and you can open that file, and you can, let's see, I think you click there, open source in editor, there we go, and you can start by doing these kind of things. You can start learning the way that the code interconnects to each other through just looking at Joomla's own components. And basically that's how I got to know how things worked. I simply went here, helper, content, control shift, then opened that in the next window, looked through the class methods, class variables, and which ones that it's extending. This one isn't extending any. So that's how I got to know how most things work, and that's also how most other developers, I suppose, are able to get their hands on this. And so the better you know the Joomla API, to the more advantage to yourself, because you'll understand that this application is really implementing the API itself over and over. I didn't reinvent things. I'm trying to stay as close to the conventions as possible. And as I become aware of better ways of implementation, I would like to add that again. So even if you know of better ways of doing it, please communicate it with me. I would gladly update and include and change whatever is needed. You must be willing to get your hands dirty. It's another one of the issues that are quite important. This simply means that if you have built something and it doesn't work, you need to debug it, which means possibly you would like to run a local sandbox environment. Now, I'm running here on Ubuntu. It's my local sandbox. And so I have PHP on it and got MySQL installed and Joomla. And so if I was to open a browser and I would type in this local This is my local install. So here you can see I just typed in VDM. And I have basically a few sites here. The test one is the one we will be working in. And the one in which Component Builder is being developed is this Component Builder one. And those sites have admin. So this is just my own little script that I've dumped onto my own little server. And I can now change that and say, okay, let's go to builder.vdm. It's all, that's another site, and it's loading some of the test displays that I'm working on. And if I add administrator to that, it'll open the backend and I can log in. So I'm running in a sandbox environment, and what this, the advantage is you don't have any internet involvement. Those of you that already do it know all these advantages, but those of you who don't, you can basically work offline mostly, and as well you can add things like Xdebug and other scripts which help you debug your application very easily. Which doing that in a online developing offsite environment is time consuming and difficult and expensive. So it's much easier doing it offline. And again, if you don't know how to do that, please visit lynda.com and look at a course called, I think it was, what was it, Up and Running with PHP Linux Developer, Linux Server, Up and Running Linux. So wait, let me quickly go find that. Hold on. Okay, here we have it, Up and Running with Linux for PHP Developers by John Peck. This is an excellent course to get your own local developing environment set up. I don't know if this URL is going to be helpful, but there it is. Apache tutorials, Up and Running, Linux, PHP Developers. And I'm sure if you've watched this, I've watched it many moons ago, and it's been very helpful to get my initial sandbox set up. Obviously since then, and I suppose with yourself as well, you'll find that you get better at it and you find better ways, but it's a good place to start. Okay, so that is about getting your hands dirty. Component Builder, best place of being functional is offline. If you're going to do it online, please realize that there might be security risks, especially when you've compiled an application. It places it into your temporary folder, which can be accessed from anywhere. Anyone can access your temporary folder on your server of your website. So yes, you can delete the application from there immediately with a button, which I'll show you later. But it is still, I feel, unsafe. And the purpose of the application was to live in a developing environment where you have Joomla installed and where you can really test it intensely. So I would still suggest it nonetheless, you do it that way. Okay, now finally we're almost there, finished with the introduction. Since it's free, please help me to ensure the future of this component by not sharing its training videos online or with anyone else. This is really the only way that I can sustain this development, is if you don't share these videos. So please, if you'd be so kind, if you have an organization or you're a company and you have others that's gonna view it, I suppose I can't stop you from doing that, but I would encourage you therefore then to consider making a contribution when you are starting to, you know, reap the benefits of the time that this application saves you, so that this application can be further developed for the rest of the community and also for yourself. We would like to also involve you on GitHub, so you can go to GitHub /vdm-io/Joomla Component Builder. Okay, it's basically this place here. And if you have issues or any requests or anything really, please come here and go to issues and open a new issue. I will ensure that you can do that if you've got an account, of course, with GitHub. And then we at least our discussions here are logged and it's public and others can see it. And we can also come back as to it and reference. If you want to make a feature request, then you can start that feature request obviously here in the issues. And possibly if it exists, I'll point you out to it. And if a training is needed, we'll add it to this training video set. But if there is a feature request that has started here and it feels that you can't wait, because we possibly will create milestones and we'll add feature requests to milestones. And if you want to ensure that a feature request ends up being done like before anyone else's, then you need to communicate with me at this email and I can send you a link to make a donation or I'll give you an invoice even if needed, so that we can ensure that feature request be done before others. Okay, so that's maybe all of it, just looking at sort of an introduction. If you have any questions, please let me know. Obviously not regarding the component itself, but just these points I've mentioned, I would be grateful. Okay, let's get on with it. Since I'm really looking forward to showing you how everything works.